وإيضاحه. And to give more clarification, it is that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warned from following the ways of the disbelievers from the previous nations, من الأمم الماضية. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and although this is khabar, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلُكُمْ, this is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informing of that which will occur. And this no doubt is from the signs of the truthfulness of the Prophet of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا من أعلام نبوته صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because no doubt what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed of has occurred. And that which is intended behind this khabar of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم is tahdhir. It's to warn from following the ways of the previous nations. So he brings the first hadith in this chapter. Hadith number 7319. حدثنا أحمد بن يونس حدثنا ابن أبي ذئب عن المقبري عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا تقوم الساعة حتى تأخذ أمتي بأخذ القرون قبلها شبرا بشبر وذراعا بذراع. فقيل يا رسول الله أكفارس والروم؟ فقال ومن الناس إلا أولئك. نعبد أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه from the Messenger of Allah, from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who said that the hour will not be established until some of my ummah takes the ways of the previous nations before them. Shibran bi shibr, handspan by handspan, وذراعاً بذراع, ذراع, armspan by armspan. So it was said, O Messenger of Allah, do you mean like the ways of the Persians and the Romans? And the Prophet ﷺ said, is anyone intended but them? Is anyone intended behind this but anyone but them? And this istifham here is istifham inkari. This is a question of inkar, of rebuke. The Prophet ﷺ, he's rebuking now. It is intended. Faris wa Rum. These are those who are intended behind this statement. Now, and the reason why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned Faris wa Rum, يعني الأمتين المشهورتين في ذلك الوقت, because they were the two يعني well-known umam of that particular time. Faris in the Mashriq and Rum in the يعني في المغرب. And Faris يعني the Fars, the Persians, who were ruled by Kisra, the Persians who were ruled by Kisra, والروم and the Romans who were ruled, they were under the rule of a يعني قيصر. And the Dawlat al-Faris, they were Majusiya. They were Magians. And their belief, their religion was that of the Majus, fire worshippers. And al-Rum, they were Nasara, Nasraniya. They were Christians. So as for a statement, alayhi salatu wassalam, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ إِلَّا أُولَٰئِكَ, who are the people besides them? Meaning, Sheikh Ubaidi says, فَارِسْ وَالْرُومِ لِكَوْنِهِمْ كَانُوا إِذَّاكَ أَكْبَرْ مُلُوكِ الْأَرْضِ, that which he intended were the Persians and the Romans, because they at that time, they had the biggest reign, يعني, that was known upon the earth. وَأَكْثَرُهُمْ رَعِيَّةٍ, they had the most people under them. وَأَوْسَعُهُمْ بِلَادٍ, they had the most vast of lands. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warned from following their ways, alayhi salatu wa salam. Sheikh Ubaidi says, وَالشَّاهِدُ مِنْهُ. So the shahid and the point from this hadith, تَحْذِيرُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ مِنْ مَسْلَكْ هَاتَيْنِ الْأُمَّتَيْنِ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم warned from treading the path of these two nations. Why? Because they are from the kuffar. Naam. So this is a warning, ikhwan, from imitating those previous nations from al-Faris wa al-Rum. And those like them, as we're going to hear, inshallah ta'ala, this was just ala sabil al-mithal, la sabil al-hasr. This is just an example from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because these were the umam that were known during that time. Those great umam that were known. But it's not to be restricted to them. The next hadith, the following hadith, which is hadith 7320, Imam Bukhari, he says, حدثنا محمد بن عبد العزيز حدثنا أبو عمر الصنعاني من اليمن عن زيد بن أسلم عن عطاء بن يسار عن أبي سعيد الخدري عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لتتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم شبرا شبرا وذراعا بذراع حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب تبعتموهم قلنا يا رسول الله اليهود والنصارى قال فمن. Likewise from the messenger, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, indeed you will follow the ways of those who came before you, handspan by handspan, armspan by armspan, up until the point that they were to enter the hole of a dhabb, a lizard, then you will follow them. Then you will follow them. Again, this is tahdhir from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from following the ways of the kuffar. He said, قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. He said, O Messenger of Allah. We said, O Messenger of Allah. Do you intend by that the Jews and the Christians? He said, فَمَنْ. Then who? نعم. So again, ikhwan, this is khabar from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of that which will occur in his ummah. And that which is meant behind this is tahdhir, warning his ummah from falling into that. Warning his ummah from falling into that. And that doesn't mean, as the ulama, they explain, that this will occur to all of the ummah. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي على الحق ظاهرين. That they will not cease to be a group from my ummah manifest upon the truth. لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم ظاهرون. They will not be harmed by those who forsake them nor those who oppose them until the command of Allah comes, يعني until يوم القيامة, until that ريح that will take the soul of the believers. وَهُمْ ظَاهِرُونَ. They will be manifest. So that's a bushra for the people of the sunnah. But this hadith, ikhwan, is a tahdhir of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from following the ways of the Jews and the Christians and the kuffar, umuman, even the wathaniyin, the idol worshippers. Because this can lead to destruction for the Muslim. And Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he authored a tremendous book, a work in which there is no nadir, there is no similitude, and that which he authored regarding this issue of opposing the kuffar and not following the kuffar, there's no book like it, as Shaykh al-Albani he mentions. Anybody know the book? Anybody know the name of the book? اقتضاء صراط المستقيم مخالفة أصحاب الجحيم. Tremendous book. Tremendous book, يا أخوان, inshallah ta'ala, بإذن الله. We hope that it will, a copy will be rendered in the English language soon, بإذن الله ta'ala. But those who know the Arabic language, then the book is present. And there, some of the ulama have explained it from them, Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan. He has a tremendous explanation. You can find it The audios are on YouTube, and likewise is printed this matbu' for those who would like to obtain a very tremendous book by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. And he mentions these ahadith. Now, so this is a warning from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the meaning of when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, shibran bi shibr, wa dhira'an bi dhira', hand span by hand span, arm span by arm span, up until they enter the lizard's hole, then you would do so. That which is meant by this is shiddatil muwafaqati lahum. You will find those, this is an example of how you will find those who seek to resemble them, or resemblance will occur down to the wire. Yani in exactness. You will find those who resemble these individuals. Exact resemblance. Hand span by hand span, arm span by arm span. As it comes in another narration, قُذَّ بِالْقُذَّ. Naam. Shaykh Ubayd hafidhullah ta'ala, he says, فَبَانَ بِهَذَا كُلِّهِ شَاهِدُ الترجمة مِنْ الْحَدِيثَيْنِ. So the point of the chapter heading and these two ahadith, naam. So it becomes clear the point of the chapter heading from these two hadith. And is that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warned every Muslim and every Muslima from following the kuffar, from imitating the kuffar. وَسُلُوكْ مَسْلَكِهِمْ and from following their ways. Whether they're from the kuffar of Ahl Kitab, the Jews and the Christians, or Wathaniyin, or whether they're from the idol worshippers. Nah. Because no doubt, ya ikhwan, following and imitating the kuffar, number one, it goes against al-i'tisam bil-kitabi wa-sunnah. It opposes al-i'tisam, clinging onto the kitab and sunnah, which is this chapter that we're in Sahih Bukhari. And likewise, imitating the kuffar, it could be a matter of fisq, or it can lead to a matter of kufr, as the ulama they explain. If a person follows them and imitates them in their i'tiqad, their belief. If you find those who follow them and imitate them in their belief and their i'tiqad, then this can yasul ila kufr. Now. So how many of those did you find? They call to wahdatul adyan, yani interfaith dialogue, interfaith yani meetings and dialogue and the likes of these matters. And those who say that, for example, these are yani the adyan as-samawiyya, and these books are books samawiyya, is the Quran and the Torah and the Injil. Now, fil asl, they are. The Torah and the Injil, as Sheikh Salih Fawzan explains. Kutub samawiyya, fil asl. But now after they've been, yani buddilu, yani wuhurrif, buddilat wuhurrifat, they've been changed. And they've been, yani, been distorted. And that which remains from the haq, the Quran. Naam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَمُحَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. Anything that was sahih in those previous books, we find it in the Qur'an. We find it in the book of Allah, the Qur'an. Naam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from anyone anything besides Islam. Yani that which Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. وَمَنْ يَبَتِ غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقَبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Whomsoever desires other than Islam as a religion, it will not be accepted from them. And they will be in the hereafter from the losers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The only religion with Allah is Islam. So as for those who call for to wahdat al-adyan.